If you were in Milwaukee, there's a good chance you remember exactly where you were 10 years ago tomorrow. That's the day Big Blue, the gigantic crane being used to build Miller Park, came crashing down, killing three workers.
That day, 12 News' Kent Wainscott brought us the first live report from the scene. Tonight, he looks back.
This was our vantage point that day. Minutes after the crane collapse, we came up over this hill to witness a sight that would stun this community.
The twisted wreckage of a massive construction crane spilled over the crushed shell of the city's newest landmark. Soon, we would all see how the accident happened as it happened, from video shot by a safety inspector on the ground.
What the hell is that? What's going on here? Okay, watch it, watch it!
Most tragic of all, the deaths of three ironworkers, Jeff Wischer, William DeGrave, and Jerome Starr, killed when the out-of-control wreckage struck the cage carrying them hundreds of feet in the air.
The most tragic day of my professional career.
Mike Duckett was and still is executive director of the Stadium District Board. He recalls arriving on the scene minutes after the collapse.
My first thought was, we'll fix the concrete and the steel. I don't know if we'll ever be able to fix the lives that were affected by that tragic accident, though.
The construction project in itself had been a showcase, a modern new ballpark with a state-of-the-art retractable dome roof. And to help build it, one of the world's largest construction cranes with its own nickname, Big Blue. On July 14, 1999, less than 9 months before the stadium was set to open, a section of roof weighing more than 400 tons was being picked or set in place. But there were high winds that day, which had some people concerned.
It was definitely an accident that could have been prevented.
Lyle Bellastrary heads the Building and Construction Trades Council and says some on the scene that day wanted the stadium builder, Mitsubishi Industries, to cancel the lift. But that didn't happen.
Maybe there could have been something else that could have been done to stop that pick that day. I wish I knew what it was. It would give me some closure.
The new stadium had not been without controversy. A regional sales tax hike had generated a lot of opposition and anger. But in the days after the accident, the community seemed to pull together.
The community rallied around the project after the accident, where a lot of the little bickering became pretty insignificant.
The accident would set the project back just 1 year as workers quickly set out to repair the damage and complete the ballpark.
They did it in memory of the guys that had fallen. So you can't ask for better than that.
And in the end, he says, the tragedy at Miller Park has left a legacy of increased safety awareness for crane operators and the construction industry as a whole.
What Miller Park did was heighten the awareness of what safety really means and how things can go wrong in just a split second.
Today, a memorial stands near the home plate entrance to honor those who built the ballpark and those who died here. And a decade later, baseball fans still think back to that tragic day.
I think you always have to remember it when you were walking in the main doors at home plate.
I keep thinking about that once in a while. You know, it comes back. God rest their souls, the gentlemen who lost their lives to build this stadium for us.
Since that day, there have been countless memories created for baseball fans here at Miller Park. But the memory of what happened here on that July day 10 years ago will stay with this community forever. At Miller Park, I'm Kent Wainscott, WISN 12 News.
Court testimony after the accident showed several factors may have contributed to the crane collapse, but high winds are still considered the leading cause. The families of the three victims eventually reached a settlement with the construction company, believed to be in the tens of millions of dollars. 12 News attempted to reach out to the families, but attorneys and union officials say the family members have chosen to keep a low profile.